Hey everyone, this is Michael Lindsay from Vital MX, and welcome to a new feature we're trying out. This is going to be Live Ride, presented by the guys at Boys N Racing. Big thank you for them covering this feature so we can give it a shot. Always looking at new style content to do, and I always love that in the mountain bike world, you know, guys are kind of able to ride and talk and give you feedback on the bike. So we've rigged up something here. We're going to give it a shot with Moto. Going to go out, spin some laps on this 2023 Husqvarna FC250 here and give you our thoughts while riding, talk a little bit about what it's like in the moment, some of the stuff that we've noticed with the bike as we have been riding it. This is my, I think, fifth time riding this bike, at least fourth. We're here at Glen Helen Day. It is freshly ripped and ready to rock and roll. Like I said, I have ridden the bike now a couple different places, so some of my feedback's gonna be based on that, because of course the track is fresh this morning where we're riding, so not a lot of bumps, so some of the handling feedback is gonna be a little based on what I've already noticed with the bike. And yeah, let's get a roll here. We'll get warmed up. So it's 2023 Husky FC250. It is pretty much all new. New chassis, that being the biggest departure, I think, versus what they've done in the past. I guess I say that the engine is equally changed on this one. So the 450 and 350 got minor engine updates. This 250, on the other hand, was pretty heavily new. All newborn stroke, 3 millimeters larger, a bore. They claim their goal was more mid-range, a little more torque feel. Oh, geez, it's muddy. And it's definitely improved in certain areas, but arguably a little worse than others. Biggest one being the bottom end. Now, don't get me wrong, the Austrian 250s have never really been known as torque monsters. They do make good low end, but it's always been in a pretty linear fashion. So I think it deceives a lot of people how much torque there really was in that outgoing engine. Get over onto this engine. Oh, it's muddy right here. Definitely less right off the bottom. Gonna be sick today once it breaks in. I'm the only guy out here. Again, engine's all new. A lot better mid-range. Definitely a lot peppier, a lot more it has a harder hit point, but what I think some people misinterpret is hit meaning low end. This bike definitely has a little more of a dead spot right off the bottom than the outgoing model. And then it hits kind of going into the mid-range. So it feels exciting. It's definitely a little more punchy, explosive, and fun in some ways, but in with that, it is also not as connected. Like when you come off the corners, it's just not as easy to roll on the throttle and feel like it's doing exactly what you're telling it to. It tends to feel a bit now like, oh, it's so deep. Can't even hit the corner. The low end now is just a bit not as connected. The mid-range is more punchy. Comes on a little bit harsher. So, feels fun and exciting, but just kind of harder to connect from section to section for the most part. And then she still revs like the outgoing gen bike, but it feels like it gets into the rev limiter a little bit quicker, a little harsher, maybe not quite as endless feeling up top as the outgoing bike. Chassis wise, I'm on a split opinion of what if the chassis update's been good or not. For my riding style, more rear steer, more on the power. Oh, I gotta cut in some lines. The rear end connection is better. It's a little more rigid in places, but I feel like I really understand where the rear end is at better on this chassis. However, in saying that, the front is the opposite. The front end is a little more vague. It's a little more comfortable. Front end's a little more comfortable, but it's not as connected feeling. Not as planted. It's not as, doesn't turn in as quick. Definitely a little more vague. If you're more of a mid to rear steer guy on the bike, probably won't bother you. Some of the added comfort might even be a positive. But if you're all front end input, you're gonna notice some vagueness, some lack of feedback to the hands. It's just not as rigid feeling front. The weight bias of the bike is definitely more towards the rear. See if we can get up this dang hill. Oh, it's so deep out there on the outside. Oh, come on! Woo! Suspension-wise, the Husky production bikes last year and this year, when I say production, I mean the non-factory Rockstar editions, are lowered. 10 millimeters front and rear. Lowers the center of gravity. Supposed to improve the turn in, the handling, etc. And yes, there is some heavy truth to that. Turn in is definitely better. But the lowered suspension to me isn't as plush so far. Yes, I feel the positive of the lower they're trying. It does turn in easier. You feel lower to ground a little better, like mid-rut on, but the Husky also seems to be on a little bit softer setting while being 10 millimeters lower. So it's, for me, hard to ride aggressively. It just feels low in the stroke, often. And when it feels low in the stroke, it feels harsh. Like if we rode here last week, you jump off this and it gets braking bumps and just, you can feel the handlebars in your hand pretty bad. Wow, still blowing that corner. So it's very hard for me to so far feel comfortable under heavy braking. So not as much comfort, not as much KTM. The bit we've rode it, I've gone higher on sag. I think their base recommendation is like 103. I've gone all the way to 100. Push the forks out of it. Just try to raise the ride height of the motorcycle and get it more feeling like it's Orange Brethren. Stiffen up a little bit. Then it starts to come around. I definitely say the suspension setting for the lowered set is better this year than last year. I thought last year's was pretty horrendous, to be honest. So, definitely improvement, but still not quite what I'm looking for. Everything I do is to get it feeling more like the KTM. Sort of get it away from that lowered feel that they went for. So I don't know. Split decision again. I see the positives, and it's definitely, in my opinion, moving in the right direction, but it still wouldn't be my first choice. I think it's better on the bigger bike, like the 450, of course. It's just on a 250. They already handle pretty darn good, so it's hard to really see the benefit. So you can just hear it down there, down low. It just kind of labors a little more. When you try to hit corners in third, it just doesn't come to life super quick. The more open air box lid definitely helps. I'm split decision on the mapping. I'm on the standard map right now, and it's more connected, which is nice. I like the feel of it more, actuating it through the corners. Sloppy, sloppy. But it doesn't rev as quick. It can feel really drowned out if you're not shifting correctly or really lacking on torque. The more aggressive map is fun. It's exciting, but it blows through the power at the very top end. I don't like how it gets into the limiter character, but then mostly down low, it's just not as connected when traction's lacking. Still skipping the muddy corner. All in all, this one's a tough one because I can name off a list of things I think they're better than last year's model. I think the suspension is improved. I think the chassis is a split decision depending on riding style. Rear steer, good. Front steer, maybe not as good. But engine, same thing. I think a lot of your Joe Blows, vet riders will jump on and feel that mid-range excitement and be like, yeah, this is better. But like a really well-tuned rider going into a pro might notice the lack of spread power as much on this motor. And if you've heard, the race team side has been a little more vocal against the bike this year. I think they're still trying to match the power output of that outgoing engine for those guys. The Husky overall is a tick more smooth and linear than the KTM. The airbox is still a little different this year, so that's the majority of that. I think it is more consumer driven than their outgoing bike, looking for that punch, that feel. And even when we went to the intros for this model, or more the Rockstar and factory editions, that's kind of what some of the product team told us. Like, this is very based off consumer feedback, not as much off what the pros want. So lower center of gravity, they're trying to get the bike to handle the better for maybe the guys that aren't as well versed in cornering. And the engine, again, being more playful, is kind of just more for the Joe Blows of the world. The guys who want excitement. They want fun factor. This is more that. That's kind of my on-the-bike thoughts of this 2023 Husqvarna FC250. Like I said, this is a feature we definitely want to do more of. Like to hear your thoughts and opinions. I definitely like to mix more setup tips, gearing tips, as we play with these bikes more. But again, this is the first trial, so let us know what you think. Throw it in the comments section below. Let me know what you'd like to see, if you guys are down for this kind of stuff or what. In the meantime, thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, and tune in for more videos.